Hi, Mel.
Oh my God. Love, pinaghandaan mo talaga ako today.
Actually, I have a confession to make. So, I went on your IGTV because I knew you were having a discussion with Kylie. And I was like, I know that I need to see how Kylie is dressed because that girl loves dressing up. You know me. Like, this is the complete opposite of who I am on a daily basis. But I'm like, Kylie will set the tone for today. So if I don't follow that, then it's going to go down the drain. So Kylie, you set the standard for today's IG Live for the Philippines.
Okay, feeling ko paghahandaan din to ni Pia tomorrow. Sobrang na-pressure ako sa inyong dalawa. Oh my God!
Sorry, ay nakahikaw si Kylie. Sige, maghikaw din ako. Tara.
Oh my God. So yun yung pangbungad na ano natin, ng IG Live natin. So kung paano natin pinaghandaan tong IG Live na to.
Yes.
So, Love, thank you so much for joining me this afternoon.
Yeah, actually, I'm super happy to be here.
Like, as in, last week ko pa talaga naisip na invite ka. Sabi ko, hindi ko lang alam kung paano ko sasabihin. Nahihiya talaga ako. Hindi
ko bakit ka naman nahihiya? Ikaw pa?
I don't know. Eh, lagi naman tayo magka-chika dun sa through DM. Pero nahihiya pa din talaga ako. I don't know. So, okay. Erase. So, let's proceed sa pagiging topic natin and pag-chismisan natin this.
Wow, chismis talaga.
No, chismis in a good way. In a good way naman.
Wala akong alam na chismis ha, just so you know. Ako walang alam na chismis.
Ito, chika, about your pageant experience before.
Okay. Yeah. By the way, I just want to say hi to everybody that's watching. You're probably watching from earlier also, so thanks for joining us. And I just wanted to ask if nag-feedback ba sa inyo? Kasi syempre, it plays, like, Oil's voice plays on my phone. So, okay naman siya? Okay, cool.
Yeah, okay. Okay naman siya. So, thank you. So, guys, ganito talaga kami ni Megan mag-usap kahit sa personal and kahit sa DM. Ganito talaga kami magkwentuhan. Wala lang, chill lang, ganon. So, it's casual lang. Gagawin natin casual yung usapan natin ngayon. So, before that, magti-thank you lang ulit ako for the third time. Thank you, Megan, for joining me this afternoon. Kasi, super nakakataba ng puso. Like, hey. It's our first Miss World. The best Miss World ever, sabi nga na. And nakakausap ko through IG Live. So, thank you for joining me. And, ayun, thank you. Napinaghandaan mo talaga ako. Isa yun sa nakakatamad ng puso. Pinaghandaan talaga ako. So, eto na nga. Ang first question to Love is, just like yung question ko din kay Kylie kanina, before kami mag-go sa Q&A namin, kamusta ang isang Megan yung simula nung mag-start or i-implement yung lockdown, yung ECQ, kamusta ka? Kamusta? Ano yung nabago sa'yo, sa tingin mo?
Two months. Actually, kanina nag-uusap kami ni Lauren and parang halos 60 days na tayo in quarantine, especially from Metro Manila. But honestly, my life kasi before quarantine revolved around work, so I'd be out a lot, but then at the same time I also had a lot of work that I could do at home. So I have the streaming, I have online content that I do from the comforts of our own home, and not a lot has changed. I think what has changed is I'm a very homebody and sa bahay. So if you're asking me quarantine or staying in one place for like a long period of time, for me, I'm okay with that because that's my personality. So I haven't been affected by it in that sense. So yeah, that's how it's been treating me so far.
Oh, thank you, Meg, for sharing that. Kung alam niyo lang, guys, kasi si Megan yung isa sa nakakausap ko when it comes to anime. Speaking of anime, siya talaga yung isa sa nakakausap ko about that. And super thankful ako kasi one message away lang si Megan. Like, hindi mo mapa, hindi ka ba mahihiyang mag-message sa kanya? Pero last time nahiya ako to ask you for our IG live. Ewan ko, that time nahiya talaga. Pero yung ibang question, natatanong ko naman, pero yung mag-ask ng IG live, ay, hello cutie! Hello!
So ba? Mag-hello lang siya, sorry.
Hi! Ang cute-cute niya talaga.
Oh, anyways, we can continue. Tapos nakaganito lang ako. Hi, Yish!
Ang cute-cute niya. Nag-comment si ano, si Rabia, yung candidate ng Miss Universe Philippines, yung super love na love ka. Na
oh, hello!
Ka-face mo yan minsan.
Mm-mm. Love it. Hi, Twitty.
So, and kamusta nga pala, love, ang isang Megan Young Daez?
I think we should ask Mikael how it's like being Mikael Daez Young. Let's turn it the other way around. No, it's been pretty good. Married life for us has not been that much different, I would say. I think the only thing that's different now is the fact that we're legally married. But everything about us and our relationship, Mick and I are very open to each other about, you know, our thoughts, our experiences, and hindi kami nagkukulang na magkwento sa isa't isa, or kung may problema kami, hindi kami nagkulang na harapin yun together. So, there hasn't been much change because honesty and being completely open with each other is something that we've practiced for the 10 years of our relationship, or halos 10 years of our relationship.
Mapapasana all ka talaga. Siguro isa yan sa key na isang successful relationship talaga. Siguro maging honest sa isa't isa, mag-share kung may problem ka man, may problem tong isa. Siguro bilang as a partner siguro, kailangan magkatuwang niyo talagang kakaharapin yung bawat hamon ng buhay niyo.
Yeah, diba? Kailangan talaga. Communication is key talaga.
I love it. And kasi one time, nakasama ko na kayo ni Mikael sa Green Hill. Ay, Greenfield.
Yeah, Greenfield.
Nagbenta-benta tayo.
Nag-bazaar tayo.
Yeah. And dun pa lang, though hindi ko kayo nakasama after that, I mean, that's the first time lang na nakasama ko kayo. And nakita ko talaga dun kung ano yung isang Mikael at Megan Young. Like, as in, super sweet. Like, sana all. As in, guys, isa sa ano, pinaka tinitingala ng mga mag-couples dyan. Guys, Megan and Mikael.
Thank you, Aya.
Go. I love you. I love you. So, after that, kasi last night, just like sa ginawa ko kay Laura, kay Ate Angelia, kay Kylie, kay Ate Janine, nag-ask din ako sa followers ko na baka may mga questions sila. Like question lang naman na Hindi intriga.
Hindi intriga, yeah.
Oo, bawal tayo doon. Doon lang tayo sa mga live.
Happy vibes.
Love, yung first question is yung about sa Miss World. Pero yung first question, wait lang. Nawala yung question. Where are you? Question.
Hanapin mo na.
Hanapin ko na. Napre-pressure kasi ako kasi isang may ganyang yung kausap ko.
Grabe to.
Oh, love. Ito yung first question, which is from CJB. Sabi niya, how does it feels when the pageant fans are calling you the best Miss World ever?
I think it's kind of surreal or kind of crazy to think about it kasi those were the words that I said when I won the Miss World crown. Yeah. And at that time, what I was feeling was, I just want to make sure that I'm the best version of myself. Like, I'm not here to, you know, seem better than other people, but I just want to make the most out of what I have and out of the year that I have to look forward to. So when they say the best Miss World ever, I can think of so many people that did a much greater job than I did. But I think each experience is unique. And I don't, like, if I'm gonna put myself lucky. Like, I don't think that I was the best, but I think I had an amazing year. I think that it was a year that I'll never forget, and I hope that the Filipinos never forget, because it was such an amazing time for all of us in a year of pageantry.
Yeah. Actually, ano, hi, hello, sino pumasok, Char?
Si Mr. Daes.
Hello, hello.
So, yeah, I did show Sola kanina. Hello daw.
Hi. So, ayun, segue ko lang, like, ayun nga, sinasabi ng, actually ako, lagi ko talaga sinasabi na you are the best Miss World sa amin, para sa akin at para sa amin. Like, imagine, can you imagine, ilang years kasi tayong nag-wait for the crown.
Hello, what's up?
Oh my God, nakakahiya naman.
Thank you, Chesney.
Naloko na pressure. Ayoko na.
Go game, manonood ako ng interview.
Parang ayoko na, Mick. Mick, huwag gano'n. Napapressure ako
na. Kailangan na naman yung
host ng video. Nawawala ako sa focus. Nawawala ako. Ako, pag nagkaroon ka naman ng ganyang husband, ayoko na balik ng bahay. Sa bahay na lang ako. Forever bahay lang. Ganon. Very supportive talaga ni me. So, ayun. Yun nga. Yung part na best Miss World ever. So, kung para sa iba, hindi man ikaw, pero alam mo yun, marami kasing naniniwala kasi sa'yo eh. You are our first Miss World, Filipina Miss World. And iba yung honor na nadala mo sa atin, sa bansa natin. Like, ikaw yung kumumpleto sa lahat ng kulang sa Philippine pageantry. And, ayun, sobrang nakakataba lang ng puso. Kasi, di ba, nakikwento ko naman sa'yo kung gano'n pa rin ako ka-proud sa'yo as our Miss World 2017. And hindi yun magbabago kahit 2020 na ngayon, kahit hanggang nabubuhay ako, you are our best Miss World ever.
Thank you. It means a lot.
Diba? Grabe talaga. Kasi kakatapos na nung may gandang serye natin, eh nalaman natin din yung mga side stories, yeah. Yung mga...
Nakakatuwa, no? Like, ako natutuwa ako dun sa serye na mga serye na ginagawa mo. Kasi... there are so many stories that a lot of people or a lot of pageant fans don't know, because you only know them if you're the girl experiencing it, if you're a friend or somebody within the org. Because I guess what you guys see is whatever you get, like whatever's posted, whatever people share. But there's a lot of stories that can't be shared, I guess, because they're kind of like the golden secret or the unspoken rule. And wala lang, it's just funny because I mean, if you talk to like the pageant girls, there's always like these kinds of stories, and I'm sure along the way you'll also unearth all these cool secrets. They're not like bad secrets, but they're pretty fun facts that you learn along
the way. Like, super kulit nga eh. Like, you, Kylie, and Tia. Like, mag-share talaga. Sabi ko, oh my God. Ginugulo talaga nila ang puso at isipan ng pageant. Kasi talaga, grabe yung mga sinishare ninyo. Like, kakaiba. Like, oh my God, nangyari pala tayo to. Like, what happened to you before mag-start ang top model competition?
Top model? Oo, grabe yun.
Grabe yung love.
Oh, sobra, alam mo ba? So, parang syempre, like, you're in pageant mode. So,
Let's
do this. Think murder. As in, ganun talaga yung mga pinupush ko ng time na yon. And the girl in front of me was already called. So, ang next dun, yung nasa kabilang side. And I have to prepare.
Okay.
So, I'm ready na. Prepared na ako. And I'm practicing in my dress. And the floor is really slippery. So, I trip on my dress. Tapos, hulog talaga ako. As in, sakit sa balakang ko. Ganun talaga. So, it was a very shocking moment because you're like, oh my gosh, I'm next. Tapos, nahulog ako. Anong mangyayari? So, kahit na medyo in pain ka dahil nahulog ka, kailangan tuloy-tuloy lang. Kunwari, wala nangyari.
Tapos, di ba, sabi mo talagang na nasira siya from here? Tama ba?
Oo. So, parang from the left side yata. Parang it's mesh kasi. So, from the left side, it's like, wasak siya, girl.
Wasak talaga.
Wasak talaga. Tapos sabi ni Princess Ayumira, huwag mong sasabihin sa iba na nasira, na nasira. Sabi ko, but it's true, it happened. Kasi ang liit ng size nila, like, na-realize ko nung time na yon, sobrang liit ko. Like, I was really skinny, and the dress was even smaller, so, ano kaya magkakasya sa akin yun ngayon? Iniisip ko, grabe, sobrang liit talaga ng damit na yon.
Oh, diba, guys? Coming from our Miss World talaga mismo, hindi lang sa comment section ninyo nalaman, kundi sa IG Live na nahulog talaga siya, nadula before the top model competition. So, the good thing about that is, hindi ka pa rin sumuko. Laban lang kung laban. Like,
yes.
Ilang beses man tayong madapa, ang mahalaga kasi doon kung ilang beses tayong bumangon sa buhay. Oh, di ba? May hugot.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. So guys, ayan, very casual talaga ng usap namin ni Megan. Ganito talaga ang life. So love, let's proceed sa next question.
Okay.
Next question is from Dars. Sabi niya, may plans po ba kayo ulit mag-audition for Hollywood? Kasi bagay talaga yung beauty mo sa Hollywood.
Yeah, I think a lot of people thought that I was going to Hollywood. But I think these were things that were thrown out there. And okay, these were aspirations and things that a lot of people around me were hopeful for. At that time, I knew that I wasn't going to try that out right away because I had plans here already and I wanted to push forward with that. I went to the U.S. 1 year. I think it was like 2016 or 2017, just to see what my options were. But doing like research and talking to people, it does take a lot of time. And you'll have to really invest in time over there. But nung time na yun, kasi ang dami kong contracts dito sa Philippines, there were a lot of things holding me back from going there. So I didn't want to cancel my commitments. But the great thing about this day and age is that everything's digital. Auditions don't necessarily have to be in person all the time. So, and I think it's a great time because a lot of international productions are looking at Asians and they're looking for more Asians. So there have been auditions that I've done from the comfort of my home during quarantine, before quarantine. And it's really a matter of luck. It's like pageants, a matter of luck, good timing. Is it right for you? So one thing that I always tell my friends is you just have to pray for it. Keep on trying. And I don't know if it'll happen for me. I don't want to feel bad if it doesn't. But if it does, then that's a great thing. So for me, just keep sending. Like if there's like an audition that they send me, I'll do it and I'll send it. And we wait. So ganun lang siya. I have to continue with my life pa rin, even if I'm doing this.
Oo, kasi wala naman talagang mawawala sa atin kung hindi natin susubukan. Wala namang masama kung magta-try ng isang bagay.
Exactly. Pero like, at the back of my head also, I'm like, syempre, kailangan pa rin kumita. So I have to continue with my day job. But yeah, I don't want to stop trying. So, ayan. Oh, wait, somebody, sorry, Aya. I'm gonna cut you off for a second because I love my puppy Zoe. Asked, hi, okay, Megan, where do I buy freshly roasted coffee beans during ECQ? If you're from Manila, you can get them from Chapter Coffee, from Yardstick Coffee, and so many other coffee shops are roasting beans, but those are the two coffee shops that we get from. So, yeah.
Love, gustuhin ko mang supportahan ka sa coffee mo. I can't kasi nagpapalpitate talaga ako pag nagko-coffee.
I was gonna say, yun, nagpapalpitate ka, diba?
Sobra, diba? Ako na-share ko na sa'yo. Like, sabi ko, hindi ako makarelate kay Megan kapag usapang coffee. Like, ay ka na. Unlike yung kasama ko dito sa apartment namin, love na love niya yung coffee. Pero ako, ay ka na talaga. Siguro coffee yung tatapos sa buhay ko.
Alam mo, love, gagawan kita ng dalgona na ano, na decaf. Ganun na lang, so, para hindi ka magpalpitate.
Ay, hindi ba siya nakakapagpalpitate?
Well, the coffee that we use for dalgona is decaf. So,
ah, decaf.
Yeah. Tsaka konti lang. 1 tablespoon lang siya.
As in, wala na. Warshak na warshak ako kapag nag-coffee ako. Lahat affected. Wala na. Na-share ko lang sa inyo. Kasi lagi ko talagang sinasabi yan kay Megan every time na may makikita ako sa IG story niya about coffee. Sabi ko, love, hindi na naman ako makarelay sa story mo kasi it's about coffee. Ayun. Sad. Wala lang. Side story lang yun, guys. Sorry. So, ayun, guys. May aabangan pala tayo kay Megan Yang. So, let's pray na.
Wala pa, ha? Wala pa.
What I mean is, whatever happens. Kung ano man yung ibigay ni Lord, support ka namin. Whatever it is. Go lang tayo dyan. So, let's proceed sa next question. Nakita ko lang siya sa comment section dito. Sabi ni Kath DMRS, sabi niya, what is it like seeing Priyanka Chopra, Miss Megan Chopra? Kamusta daw
nakikita
mo si Priyanka? Kamusta? Ano yung na-feel mo?
When I met her in India, parang Julia was receiving an award one time. And I didn't know I was gonna meet her. Tapos, last minute ko na lang na, uy, nandito si Priyanka. Tapos, there was like an immense kilig factor. Because I was meeting another Miss World. I was meeting a very popular Bollywood actress. And when I met her, she was just so down to earth. She was the nicest ever. Like when you see somebody of that big of a personality, you think na parang punong-puno ng bodyguards, and they'll be like, oh, you need to ask like this person first. But I was like, can I take a picture with you, please? And she's like, yeah, give me your camera. As in, ganun lang ka casual. And she was so cool and very like nonchalant about what was happening around us. She was just like, yeah, let's go. Let's take a picture. So super, super bait. And I was just like, hi, I love you. Oh, wait, I have kwento. Just to like add to that. So I met Priyanka Chopra. And in my reign, I also met Aishwarya Rai. I met Aishwarya at the final of Miss World 2014 because she was receiving an award. And during rehearsal, she was there because I was hosting the show. So we had to block her and stuff. And they were like, Megan, this is Aishwarya. And I was like, hi, I love you. That's how this happened. I said, super fangirl mode. I was just like, I love her. Super kinilig ako, super nag fangirl ako, and I kind of crumbled on the inside kasi sabi ko, oh my gosh, sobrang engot mo, Megan. Wala ka nang nasabing matino, ang nasabi mo lang, I love you. Super, it was such like an amazing experience meeting her, and she's very petite of a person kasi naka-heels ako noon eh kasi nagre-rehearse kami, but she was so beautiful, like when you see her up close. Perfect talaga.
Whew. Bongga yung moment na yan. Like, grabe no, love. Since 2014, mag host the Miss World.
Yeah, it's been an amazing ride, honestly. Who would have thought?
Yeah. Diba? Who would have thought na mangyayari yung mga ganung bagay? Like, looking forward talaga kami, and diba, na nasabi din sa'yo last time na super nakaka-excite every time na ikaw yung mag-host ng Miss World. And dito ko ipapasok yung question. I mean, nanggagaling sa mga followers, sa mga pageant fans natin from the Philippines, parang iniisip kasi ng iba na yun daw kaya yung isang reason kung bakit hindi pa ulit tayo nasusundan ng isang Miss World. Sabi ko, ganun ba yun?
Is that the basis ba of posting?
Yeah.
I thought the basis was judging the performance.
Kasi
honestly, like, whenever I hear comments like that, I really just brush it off or laugh about it because it sounds like nonsense if I think about it. But of course, like, syempre, you have to put in perspective na parang people are thinking of different theories, and I don't want to discredit that. But to me, since I have experience being behind the scenes, I'm like, bakit kaya nila naisip yun? Or paano kaya nila naisip yun? So I just brush it off, really. I mean, it doesn't really affect me or anything because I love my job. I love what I do. I'm going to continue doing it. And behind the scenes, I do try my best to support the girls in any way that I can. And I don't post about it because I think it's an experience that the girls need to go through on their own. So I help, I guide as much as I can. Pero syempre, experience nila yun eh. They make that experience their own, just like how I did and the queens before me did. Ikaw magsha-shape nun, hindi yung mga tao sa paligid mo. They add to it, yes. But all the decisions when you're there internationally, ikaw yun. Ikaw ang mag-decide nun. Ikaw ang gagawa nun. You take all the help and teachings that people gave you and you bring it to the international stage. Yo. So I don't know. So wala akong say doon. Taga-host lang po ako and I always arrive there 5 days before the final. So I have no idea what's going on pagdating ko doon.
So ayun guys, coming from Megan Yang. So sana yung may mga nag-question noon, I mean may mga nagtatanong ng ganung question, nalinawan na kayo kasi wala eh, paulit-ulit din kasi naming sinasabi sa inyo na nasa girl yon, or kung wala man sa girl, kung hindi man siya sinamahan ng luck. Yung sabi ni Rufa, na kahit gaano pa kaganda ang candidate natin, kahit gaano pa yung kagaling, katalino, kung kulang naman sa swerte, wala pa din. Kasi kailangan daw sa competition ng luck. Ng lucky charm.
Yeah. I think I had a lot of luck. Like this, kumbaga, if you wanna think about it, like the stars were probably in my favor at that time. It was the right place, the right time for me. And wala, I mean, you give what you can, but there are so many factors around you. Like it's the place. I don't. Is it the place? Is it the judges that are chosen during that time? How you're feeling? Does that also count? I don't know. Like there's so many factors put into place. I guess.
So, ayun, guys, alam niyo na, please take note.